Hello you guys and welcome to my channel. I'm so excited to have you here. So today we are going to be doing MLM horror stories like we do every single Friday. Grab your coffee, grab your popcorn, and definitely grab your tea for this one. So the first story, it's getting us off to a sad start and it has a huge like trigger warning in the beginning. It says, hello Deanna. This story talks about addiction, prescription, seizures, marital abuse, epilepsy, RLS, anxiety, and depression. I don't go into detail, but I thought I'd make some sort of disclaimer for your viewers if you decide to read this to them. I'm going to start by giving you a little background story. My late boyfriend's ex-wife is who this story is about. My late boyfriend, so her boyfriend passed. My late boyfriend broke his back at a job site many years ago before meeting his ex-wife. In that, the doctors prescribed him painkillers. He later was then diagnosed with epilepsy, RLS, anxiety, and depression. My late boyfriend passed away from a prescription. I'm gonna have to blur these words out, but a prescription. My late boyfriend had been married to this woman about 2 years before they separated, and we eventually met about a year after their separation. They have one child together. She has been an exhausting long list of MLMs, or she's been in a exhausting long list of MLMs. She never seems to get the unfavorable notion that they simply are not ever going to work for her. She has been in Unique, Q Sciences, Paparazzi's, Pharmacy, and Thrive. Fast forward to about 2 months after he passed away, she blocked all of his family members, so they had no contact with their grandchild or nephew after promising the family at the hospital she wouldn't and would remain in contact. She posts everything on her page publicly. She has never blocked me, so as a favor to the family, I willingly check in on her profile to obtain pictures of their grandchild and nephew and share them with the family. I've been doing this for several years now. She had been posting videos, graphics, and all of the typical MLM garbage on her page. This is where it gets real. She posted a very long video and titled quote unquote real talk, where she begins to tell her audience of her past and where she has been, how her upbringing hasn't been perfect, but it wasn't a horrible upbringing and so on. She then starts to bring up her failed marriage and how everything was his responsibility due to his inability to get proper help with his. This woman would have made fun of the seizures he had, told him he was making them up for attention. Anyone with even just one brain cell in their skull knows that seizures can't be mimicked or just made up. I took damn good care of him after every grand mal and tonic seizure he had while we were together. She played the role of the grieving wife with his child left behind. At the end of the video, she said, I just wanted to get real with all of you guys and let you know that all of your support is helping my son. I was sitting there watching this unfold live with all of the facts and knowledge I have about their failed marriage. I couldn't believe how disrespectful and disgraceful she was to a man she claimed to have once loved. She simply isn't here to defend himself. She never mentioned any details in her story to her viewers that would be critical to the story because those details would cast her in a light that wouldn't, or that would be unfavorable. And ultimately, it wouldn't fit her narrative in trying to recruit or sell products. Supporting my son, in other words, means buy my crappy products and join my team. It doesn't matter how low these women in these MLMs have to go in order to sell, connect with, and scam unsuspecting victims. It's disgusting and degrading to all of the single moms out there who don't join MLMs, who have honest and respectful jobs. Thank you for sharing my story. Oh, this is a really sad one. I'm so sorry for your loss, and it definitely seemed like he was going, you know, through a hard time, and it's sad that she would use someone who has passed away to her benefit, but it's something we kind of see in MLMs a lot, and I will be honest, I always try and give the benefit of the doubt to MLM reps. That's kind of how I try and be, and when you join an MLM, they always tell you, you know, you need to have a story. That's the way you connect with people. Connecting with people, having a story, that's how you sell products. That's how you recruit. So your story ends up becoming this ticket to recruitment and this ticket to selling products. So you have people who may even take their story and make it a little bit, you know, tweak some things here and there and make it not the most truthful, or not truthful, but leave things out because they want people to connect and relate with them. And that's something I see on social media, because everyone nowadays, you know, you want to follow someone that is quote unquote relatable. I like to follow people on Instagram and stuff that I can relate to, that don't just come out here and friends do all of this like unrelatable stuff, if that makes sense. So I follow people who are relatable, and I think that MLMs have tried to take that aspect of social media where people who are creators or on Instagram, on YouTube making videos, on TikTok, they want to be relatable. They're trying to take that and use it to like sell their products. And they end up doing it like this, where they craft these large stories to reel people in. And clearly she will be able, you know, this individual will be able to rope in single moms, moms who have had, you know, their spouses pass away or their child's dad pass away. And it's just really sad to see people use that. But I don't really think that a lot of MLM reps understand what they're doing. Like, they're just told by their uplines, you know, you need to tell your story. That's the best way to connect with people, and you're gonna be able to find your people that way. And I don't think they get what they're doing. He's using her boyfriend who passed away, you know, the ex or the wife's ex-husband, to her advantage. And I don't think they realize that they are doing something that's just so, I would say, unethical for like anyone that has their own business to do something like that. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you guys feel like this is a common thing with MLMs, that this is like what MLM reps do and are taught to do by the MLM, by the uplines and things like that? Because I really feel like it's something that's taught, but that doesn't make it okay to try and make up these stories to relate to people, quote unquote, lie to people so that you can recruit them. So the next story is, this MLM has saturated my community. Let's see what this is about. Oh, and they left websites and stuff. Cool. So it says, hi, Deanna. If it's okay with you, I'd like to stay anonymous. And please excuse my grammar in advance. I have binge watched your videos on YouTube, and it actually came at a perfect time when I had left an MLM. I want to share my story concerning the MLM I was part of without really knowing what I was doing. The MLM is Herbalife, but it was easily disguised through an organization called Team Beauty. This organization is official. They even have merchandise, and it is trademarked. I only know this because a while back, I uploaded a video promoting their weight loss services, and they told me to delete it or they would sue me for, oh my gosh, they better not sue me. Sue me for using their name without their permission. Anyways, I guess that was not enough for me to know. It was not a good woman empowering organization. Face slap. I am from South Texas, and I mean Sal. We live in the Rio Grande Valley. I hope I pronounced that right. Team Beauty has really taken over almost all the cities around the Rio Grande. And is it Rio Grande? Rio Grande? I'm Googling this so I don't say it wrong. Okay, I'm just gonna say Rio because I don't, is it Rio Grande? I hope so. I hate pronouncing places incorrectly. So Rio, Rio Valley. Team Beauty has been taking over almost all the cities around the Rio Valley, and it is continuing to expand. I've heard of them even having locations in Puerto Rico and Mexico. Anyways, this organization started in McAllen, Texas, and it has just gotten out of control. There are gyms and nutrition shops, you know, the typical in every city, including mine. It is also sad to see them open and close not too long after. But anyways, I believe Team Beauty / Herbalife has reached its peak market saturation in the area because I have no longer have seen people breaking through ranks. The Team Beauty, so this is like Herbalife, they seem to be the same thing. Maybe this is like someone's team name or something. I'll look into it in a little. The Team Beauty organization was able to achieve top level ranks by using quote unquote bet on me challenges and monthly transformation challenges, in which you are eligible to win money if you are a top transformation. Every time you join a transformation challenge, you need to buy a certain amount of product, which is about $100 to $150 a month, to be eligible for the cash prizes, photo shoots, or participation gifts. These depend on the type of challenge. Let's stop for a second. So you have to join a challenge, you then have to, you're already paying for products. You're already in the MLM. You're then having to pay for every challenge money in order to hopefully be eligible for a cash prize. No. Currently, they have about 7 president team members, and 2 of them are double diamond. If you know about the ranks in Herbalife, you know how hard it is to achieve these ranks. They need to have thousands of people under them. The organization has done a great job at recruiting and selling product because they focus on empowering women, and actually, that is how I got sucked in. I've always been one to love these movements, but it took a while for me to understand that I did not feel good advertising something that I didn't really benefit from or thought it was hard to achieve. To be completely honest, I never made any money because I would sell my products at the price that I would get them at. I was able to reach the 50% discount, more like 45% on the product products from personal consumption, but when I would sell them, I would sell them at the price I would pay. So I paid $50 for the products and asked for $50 from my client. I did this because I think the products are extremely expensive, but I do like most of them and knew my clients would like them too. So yeah, basically, I never made money or recruited anyone because I felt fishy doing so, knowing how expensive and pushy the organization was. On my first and only meeting with my mentor, she asked me to make, yep, here's the list of 100. This is like an MLM thing, like an MLM network marketing, direct selling, just thing that every MLM does. To make a list of 100 people that I can sell to, and was asked to message 10 of them every day until I was finished with the list, and then after I finished the list to contact her. Well, I kind of started, but felt so nasty, so I stopped. I didn't reach out to her concerning the list, and she never asked either. She never reached out to me to see how I was doing or if I needed more help. I actually tried to stay consistent on the many chats I was in, but it was overwhelming, so I went MIA. When I came back to the chats, I found out I was kicked out during an inventory. What? During an inventory of chat members? The last message I was around the lines of, okay girls, let's do an inventory. If they are not active, they don't care, and they are not making money, it's time to clean and make some space for more girls. I mean, I guess it's true. If you don't make them money, they don't need and want you. Anyways, I was hoping that someone can look into them and see what you can uncover, or at least spread the word about their practices. I think many people need to find out about their predatory methods of recruitment, and at this point, it is kind of sad that they continue to recruit because no one else will make money off the organization because it is so saturated. You can literally not scroll through Facebook without seeing a post every 10 posts, or driving down the street without seeing a nutrition shop or one of the gyms. I will leave their website here so you can check it out. I will also attach all of the files they've provided me. Oh, maybe I'll do a video. Oh, yes. Let's go to their website because they're a part of Herbalife. This is making me think this is a team name. Because whenever you join an MLM, you essentially make your own team name when you start building a team. So if you build a team, you can call it like Team Conquer. That's what I called mine. Ew. But you can call it whatever you want. You can call it Team MacBook. It doesn't freaking matter. You come up with your own cute name for your own reasons, and a lot of people will make websites based off their team name. So this could be what this is. So about us, it says, we are a community of ordinary women doing extraordinary things, coming together in three key aspects to help each other reach fitness and life breakthroughs. Seven women began in 2015, and today's tens of thousands of women have transformed themselves. So let's go to get started. So if you go to get started, it says, let's get started, see more results, I want to be a coach. But they make you fill out a form. I wanted to see if they were going to bring me straight to a link to purchase. They're smart. No, you just do a form. So then you have to get in contact with people. This is sketch. They have a YouTube channel. They're a part of Herbalife though. I love doing these like little dives with you guys where you guys can like see what I'm looking at. So we can like look at stuff together. They have a store. Okay, so they sell merch to their people. I just want to know. I think I'm going to speculate that this is a team that is in Herbalife because they talk about their nutrition and then they say we have partnered. That's something similar that a lot of people in MLMs will say. I used to say to Beachbody, they told us to tell people like we're partnered with fitness trainers, you know, the people who make the fitness programs. So they said we have partnered with the number one nutrition company in the world to help you get the best result. We show you the steps on how to create a healthy, active life and make it better for you. Did you know you can start helping people during your journey? Do you need extra income? Where to start? Locking arms. Yes, that's the recruiting aspect. Then they talk about join our fitness classes, empowerment calls, nutrition calls. See, the only thing that makes me question this is the fitness. It says those who do it with a group of people have more success. Our community will help you. This does look like a location. Oh no, but if you zoom in, it says Herbalife Nutrition. Because it makes me think that this is a team, but this is a team that has like a local spot in their community, right? That they can do actual fitness stuff. So they could do like dance classes, Zumba, whatever they feel like it, and build that community aspect that Herbalife does. You guys know I did a deep dive on Herbalife's nutrition clubs, actually. Loved that video, but I did a huge deep dive on that where I even got to question or interview technically someone who's in Herbalife doing the nutrition club. And it's very similar to this. Their nutrition clubs, they just sell shakes and stuff. Looks exactly like this in the sense of it will say Herbalife when you walk inside. Maybe not that bluntly like theirs does, but it will still say Herbalife. You'll see all the powders there, and the people in there essentially work for Herbalife, but they made their own store. So it looks like that's what these people did. And then they have like their own little name and everything like that. Let's look at what else she said or what else she sent. So she sent me their Instagram page. So they have like 8,000 followers. They talk about their retreats, photo shoots, results, and then they link their team beauty website. And then they also have like a, what, Facebook group? So yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit more research on this because I'm very, very intrigued. But just by what this person said, I think it's just like a team that works with Herbalife, just like nutrition clubs. If you actually go to a nutrition club in your area where they sell the shakes and stuff, they'll have a name because they're technically a business. Like they have had to literally rent a shop out and do all of that stuff. Even though they're Herbalife reps, they've had to rent a shop out, follow Herbalife's qualifications that they put upon them and rules they put upon them in their Herbalife shop, but they name it something. Literally, I could walk to the one we have right next to my house. I'm not gonna give the name away, but it says something nutrition, it doesn't say Herbalife. They come up with their own name to mask that they're Herbalife, if that makes sense, or to just make it to where more people will wanna come. So let's hop into the next MLM horror story. Have you guys ever looked at that? Or like, have you guys ever seen that where it's not just nutrition clubs, but it's actual like fitness areas or gyms? I know that people have told me that there are places that have the smoothie shops in a gym, but what I understood by that is the gym isn't owned by a Herbalife rep. So let me know. This says, MLM gets in the way of my morning coffee and more. Hi, Deanna. I love watching your anti-MLM content and I wanted to share a couple of my experiences with you. Oh, and I don't care if you mention my name. Okay, so this is the first one that had me heated because it got in the way of my morning coffee. So I've started going to a small coffee shop down the street from my apartment. One morning before work, I walked into the shop and the lady who is usually behind the register is doing a transaction of some sort. She and the woman dropping off the packages were having some trouble with proof of shipment, I think. They went on for literally 10 minutes going back and forth. I stood there patiently waiting, assuming this transaction was business related. No, no, no. When they finally had it figured out, the lady behind the counter opened up one of the packages. It was freaking Mary Kay products. I was so pissed when I saw that. Like, come on, man. I wanted to buy from your real business. By the time I was going to be super late for work, so I grabbed my coffee and didn't leave a tip like I usually would. It really sucks because my location of the shop is so convenient for me and the coffee is decent, but the interaction makes me not want to go back. I see why you would be frustrated if there's one person working the stand or like the front where you order your coffee, and instead of taking your order for 10 plus minutes, she was going back and forth with the Mary Kay rep. No, the Mary Kay rep can like talk to her on her own time. Like, she is on the clock, okay? That would be like walking into Starbucks or like me going into the Starbucks drive-thru and then being like, hold on one moment. Or actually, hold on 10 to 15 moments because, you know, I have to make sure that I get these MLM products. I would not go there ever again. Sorry, but you need to give me my coffee and that's what I came for. I love you. Give me my coffee and we can still be friends, Starbucks. But like, no, I would be bothered. What about you guys? She goes, second story. There's this girl I met a few years ago in college who is now a boss babe. Let's call her Cassie. When I met Cassie, she was already friends with my roommate and the three of us decided to go to the mall together. While there, she bought a ton of clothes, contemplated a new piercing, and got 17 Sephora lipsticks. Yes, I remember exactly how many. And the designer bag she was carrying was pretty damn nice too. Coming from a lower class, middle family myself, that kind of spending was wild to me. We never hung out after that, but we follow each other on Instagram. She joined Lovell maybe 2 or 3 years ago and totally sent me a cold message trying to get me to join. She's deep into it and posts this all the time. She once made a post about how her dad told her to get a real job and how wrong he was. She also qualified for the auto bonus and made a post about how she turned down a BMW because the Audi is more her style. My boyfriend's a car guy, and he said she got the cheapest one available, so I guess the auto bonus doesn't cover much. But what also makes me mention her is that she makes a bunch of income claims that I've started reporting, and she likes to say she was poor and couldn't afford anything before the MLM. She also claims to have experienced depression and anxiety from being poor, and said she used to think money was evil. I'm not saying I don't think she experienced those things. That's not for me to decide. However, I know some people in MLMs post about that kind of thing just to be relatable to their audience. See, relatability. I digress. I'm still close with my old roommate, and we both get a laugh out of the fact that she moved to LA because she was running a $1 million business. Yeah, she moved back home a year later. She still pitches the lifestyle constantly. Her Instagram stories are endless and pretty much only about the MLM. I'll link her Instagram below because I feel like there may be some good talking points on her posts for your videos. Side note, I wanted to attach a screenshot I took of the comment section for one of Jason Camper's posts. Jason Camper is the LaBelle CEO, one of the two. I cannot believe that someone posted this. I reported it right away, but it's just another look into how messed up some of these people can be. Look at the comment at the bottom of this picture. Thanks so much for reading this lengthy message and the positive content you make. Hope this finds its way to the top of your mailbox. It did, girl, it did. So I'm not gonna show you guys her Instagram, the person, the rep, because you guys know I blur people out and all that stuff. But let's see, Jason Camper made a post saying, my, do we have something up our sleeve? Hashtag ThrivePalooza. I've been steadily working on something that has me giddy excited. A new technology, a new delivery system that's different than anything available in the marketplace of, what in the heck is that word? Whatever, nutraceuticals and dietary supplements. This product launch is going to have some serious excitement and horsepower behind it. Full details revealed at this year's Palooza. Comment below what you think this new technology is. Get ready, competition. SPT is coming. Hashtag Thrive SPT. Hashtag Thrive Experience. Hashtag We Are The Innovators. Hashtag We Keep Innovating. Hashtag The One and Only Thrive. So someone commented, I'm so excited. Another one commented, my husband thinks Thrive should come. Oh no. That just shouldn't be on the internet. Jokes aside, my husband thinks Thrive should come in roofie form for those who don't think they need it. Okay, interesting. That is a little bit crazy. Someone commented under her and said, I actually suggested my husband do that to a few people he works with. It's not a joke. So 17 people liked that comment. How do you guys feel about that comment? Like, do you think people could joke about that stuff? To me, I don't see why you would want to joke about something like that. So let's do one more. So it's that, and this one got screenshots. All of these have screenshots today. I'm like excited. So it says, hi Deanna, if you choose to share this, keep everyone and me anonymous. Part one. So to preface this story, there is what I like to call a Beachbody ring that is made of people from my hometown. The lead ringer is a girl who I went to high school with and played sports with. Side note, she no longer lives in my hometown. She's a super sweet girl. She messaged me several times, however, it was conveniently never a good time for me. And I was on my own fitness journey. This was me before realizing it was an MLM. Well, underneath her is another girl I played sports with / went to school with. Then there are several under her. That particular upline has only messaged me about once or twice. The several people under her have not messaged me except for one, the girl who was mentioned in this story. Now, I don't believe that the second girl is her upline, but I do know that she is connected to the ringleader's pyramid. So girl number two and number three are both in the same pyramid together. One reason why I asked to keep everyone anonymous is because it is easy to figure out. This just comes to show how saturated the market is, especially for just one hometown. Part two. All right, so this isn't the most interesting story ever, but I have one. I'm not usually that much of a target for cold messaging. Usually when I turn someone down or ignore them, that's it. Except this one girl. I've known who she is for a while, but I've known her husband for a long time. I grew up with his sister. My friend got tagged in a giveaway post, which I am a sucker for, and I tagged her back. I never win any of them, but I actually won this one. At this time, I did not think this chick was a Beachbody coach. I just didn't invest in it, nor did I follow her on Instagram. Well, it turns out I had unleashed a beast. This has been going on for about a year now. I believe she messages me a lot because I post stuff about fitness every now and then on my stories. However, it's obvious that I'm not interested and this chick cannot take a hint. It's a running joke between me and my friends now. Screenshots are included. Let's get down to it. So the person messaged her our girl and said, yay, I'm so excited for you. If you will go to this website and pick any headband you would like under $16 and send me a pic and I'll send it to you. Also your address. So the person sent her address, sent the headband they wanted because they won the giveaway. Okay, so these have been sent a little bit out of order, but we're gonna understand what happened. So the girl says, it's been shipped to you, so the giveaway prize. Then she goes, hey girl, did you get your headband? Our girl said, yes, I did. I've been meaning to message you. I wore it on my last run last night and this morning. I love it. MLM rep says on October 30th, oh good, I'm so glad. November 11th, she messages her and says, the MLM rep messages our girl and says, hey girl, happy Monday. I'm starting my November boot camp soon and was curious if you were interested in joining. It is so much fun and I'd love to give you more info. Have a great day. November 13th, our girl said, no thanks, maybe some other time. MLM rep says, okay, do you know anything about a boot camp? So that was in November. So it goes November, December, January, February, March, April, May. 6 months later, she says, hey girl, not sure if you got my last message. What do you mean? Did you get my last message? You messaged her 6 months ago. It says, hey girl, not sure if you got my last message or not. I don't want you to think I forgot ya. Have you had a chance to consider joining one of my boot camps? Happy to help explain in some way. Hope you are staying sane during the madness. So then the next time she messages her, and our girl has not responded. So then from May to September, so January, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, 4 months later, she goes, hey, hope you're having a great Tuesday and happy September. Don't know if you saw it, but my team and I just started a brand new boot camp that I'm super excited about. It's 21 days and only 30-minute workouts and all the nutrition guidance. Does that sound like something you need right now? I know the last few times haven't been the best for you. Would love to share. Haven't been the best, girl. She has not responded. Or that was September 15th, right? Then she messages her November. So September to November, 2 months later, says, hey girl, wanted to check back in and see if you're interested in starting our next level November Fit Club. We start next Monday and I would love to tell you more about it. Does it sound like something you're interested in? Then on Thursday, so I'm guessing like this prior Thursday, meaning it's a new year. Then she goes, hey, I seen you on my page so much. Thanks for continuing to follow my journey. It means a lot. I'm starting at my February boot camp on February 8th and I'd love to have you join us. You'll get access to workout meal plans and accountability to give you a space to use as an outlet during these crazy times. Want me to save you a spot? And then that's the end of the messages. So this is something that MLM reps are taught. I was in Beachbody myself for 2 years, so I know that this is what you're taught. You're taught that like no is not no. You're taught that it's just not right now. So when someone says no, they say no. No doesn't mean no. No means not right now. So you have to keep asking. And it's embarrassing. Like I do remember doing that maybe like once or twice. And I like look back on those messages years later and I'm embarrassed. I've never gone that bad, like 2 years and crap, like messaging someone for a whole 2 years. Unless that person has been messaging me back and forth. I'm talking like if you keep messaging them and they're not responding to you after a year of you messaging them, stop messaging them. Get the vibe that they're giving off. They don't want to join. And it sucks because they're taught so much. I actually remember, let me grab a notebook so I can show you guys. I'll show you guys one of my favorite notebooks. So I'll go towards the end because I use this one from my cute to-do lists. But what I was taught Beachbody was this is what you do. You get a notebook. I definitely threw out, I wish I still had them. I threw out like 3 notebooks from my time at Beachbody. So when I wake up today, you're supposed to go in here and write down people's names. So you make a list of like 1 through whatever, however many lines are on a normal page or your notebook page. So you go like 1 through whatever. And then you write people's Instagram handle and their Instagram names in. And sometimes people will even take the page and they will fold it so you could do 2 names. So you would fold it, put a line, so you have 2 sides, and then you would do the back. And some people would make it a mission to do the front and back every day. So on a normal actual like note sheet paper, like for school, it's about 60 or 65 lines or something like that in the front and back. And that's what they tell you to do. So then what happens is you have a month, right? This says like November, like this girl, and you write someone's name. So every month you'll go back to that list and you end up with thousands of names. Like you end up with so many names that you don't remember who you recruited, like, or who you tried to recruit or who you tried to sell to. This person didn't look like she was trying to recruit her in the sense of like joining the MLM. MLM as a rep, but she was trying to get her to join her fit clubs. Oh, that's what my group is called. I have a Facebook group called Deanna Mims Fit Club. Oh well. But she wants her to join her accountability groups and buy the products, which you have to spend about $160 plus four Beachbody packages to get started as a rep. So it's pricey, but yeah, that's what they have you do. I remember that's what they had me do. That's what they teach. And it's pretty crappy because I just think at the end, like, you have so many names, you don't even remember the person you reached out to. Like, you can't remember, you know, someone's DM to another. And I feel like I have been out of Beachbody for over a year. And I actually know, like, when I look on my YouTube channel and I'm responding to comments, I know when someone's like a repeat commenter. Like, I know that someone who comments multiple times on multiple videos, I start to like remember your guys' names or your guys' faces or the names specifically that you have, because not everyone puts their name on like their YouTube channel. And that's like something cool. Like, you should be excited to be able to know, oh my God, that person watches, you know, most of my videos, or that this person is always messaging me on Instagram, love chatting with them. Like, you start to remember this. Let me tell you, I don't remember not one name. Okay, maybe like two from Beachbody, because I actually became like friends with them after we messaged each other. But yeah, it just is really crappy. I hate seeing it when I see it. So what do you guys think about that? When you were in your MLM, did you see that happening? Or have you seen like any trainings or anything like that? I should find one. I should find like an Instagram social media training and react to it. There are definitely plenty of them. I don't think I've ever reacted to one like that. I've reacted to a couple of just like motivational team calls that MLMs do. And I think, yeah, I reacted to one where they talked about hitting emeralds and everything like that in Beachbody. But I don't think I've ever done a team call where I'm reacting to what they tell you to do on social media, aka what do they tell you to do in DMs? What do they tell you to post and all of that? I feel like it could give us a lot of insight and people on this channel and you guys and the people who watch a lot of insight on what people are doing and how they're doing it on social media. So you could kind of look out for those warning signs yourself. So let me know if you want me to do that, but that is going to be all for today's video. I'm so sorry I talked most of the time. I know I did that little bit of dive into the one little team. And then I showed you guys this and I talked about DMs, but this was definitely like an interesting bunch of stories that were like different, but they all had like screenshots and stuff to look at. So I love when you guys send me stories that like look at a bunch of things. It gets me like super intrigued to look at more. So don't forget to leave a like and a comment if you would like. I love chatting with you guys, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you in the next one.